हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू कामत एस्ट्रोलॉजी। एंड दिस ईयर 2021 द हिंदू न्यू ईयर स्टार्ट्स ऑन 13th अप्रैल 2021 एंड दिस फेस्टिवल इज पॉपुलरली नोन एज उगादी और गुड़ी पाड़वा इन इंडिया। सो इन महाराष्ट्र इट इज़ नोन एज गुड़ी पाड़वा एंड इन द सदर्न स्टेट्स सच एज आंध्र प्रदेश, कर्नाटका एक्सेट्रा इट इज़ नोन एज उगादी। सो इन दिस वीडियो लेट अस एक्सप्लोर हाउ द ईयर 2021 विल बी फॉर इंडिया। नाउ ऑल्दो मोस्ट ऑफ द ऑफिसर्स विल बी गिवन अ हॉलीडे ऑन 13th अप्रैल 2021 फॉर गुड़ी पाड़वा, ओके, देर इज समथिंग कॉल्ड एज प्रतिपदा which starts on 12th April 2021 at 7:59 a.m. So what does Pratipada mean? Pratipada means the first day of the bright fortnight of the moon or the dark fortnight of the moon. So on the 1st and the 16th day of the month, you will have the Pratipada. Okay, in this case, the new year starts on the day of Amavasya, okay, that is when the sun and the moon are at the exact same degree, and this happens on 12th April 2021 at 7:59 a.m. So when you are making the New Year Kundali, you have to cast the chart based on this timing, that is 12th April 2021, 7:59 a.m. and the place will be New Delhi, because New Delhi is the capital of India. Now when the sun and the moon are at the exact same degree in a zodiac sign, it indicates the day of Amavasya or new moon day, and new moon means the starting of new beginnings and therefore the start of a new year. So now let us look at the chart cast on 12th April 2021, 7:59 a.m. New Delhi for India. Okay. Even before that, let us understand that this particular day of Gudi Padwa is also known as Chaitra Shukla Pratipada. So we know that there are two phases of the moon, that is the waxing moon and the waning moon. The waxing moon is known as Shukla Paksha and the waning phase of the moon is known as Krishna Paksha. So the new year starts in the Shukla Paksha, that is when the moon is now going to increase in size from the new moon day, okay, and this day is also known as Chaitra Shukla Pratipada. The month of April is also known as Chaitra. So the new moon day in this month of Chaitra, which indicates the starting of the Shukla Paksha, okay, that is known as Gudi Padwa or Ugadi, and this year it starts on 12th April 2021 at 7:59 a.m. So now let us look at the new year chart with this understanding. So now this is the chart drawn on 12th April 2021, 7:59 a.m. with place as New Delhi, and you can see a green circle which I have drawn in this chart. It shows that the sun and moon are conjunct in the sign of Pisces at the exact same degree, that is at 28 degrees 16 minutes almost, okay, and since the sun and moon are together in the zodiac sign, it indicates the day of Amavasya, and since they are at the exact same degree, it indicates the start of a new year. So how will this year be for India? Now when you cast this horoscope, the lagna or the first house comes as the sign of Taurus, okay. Independent India also had the lagna as the sign of Taurus, but this time when we are starting the new year, you can see that in the lagna Angarak Yog is formed, that is Rahu and Mars are conjunct together in the sign of Taurus. Had the new year started a day later, Mars or Mangal would have moved into the sign of Gemini on 14th April 2021, and that would have been much better. But unfortunately, what has happened is the new year has started when Angarak Yog is still active, and that too in the first house for India's horoscope this year. So what does the first house indicate? It indicates the body, it indicates the personality, and for a country, it indicates the people of that country. So it also indicates the situation that will be prevalent in the country throughout the year. And since Mars and Rahu are together, it forms an Angarak Yog or an explosive situation. So what does this mean? Rahu indicates viruses, okay? He indicates diseases, and Mars indicates aggression. It indicates the force within us. Okay, so this year you will find there will be a lot of struggle between the government and the people. Okay, and the virus which is there, it will also spread in a big way. It is not going to decrease so easily. Now, why am I saying this? Because if you see this chart, okay, you can see that Mars is placed in the first house with Rahu, okay, and Rahu indicates viruses, diseases, etc. Venus is the sixth lord ruling the sign of Libra or Taurus, okay, and Venus is placed in the Mesh Rashi, which is the 12th house. So it is like the 6th lord is placed in the 12th house. Now what is the 6th house all about? It is about diseases, it is about deaths, it is about conflicts. And what is the 12th house? 12th house is about expenses, it is about isolation, it is about hospitalization. Okay, so what this means is many people will be hospitalized this year because the 6th lord has moved into the 12th house, which also indicates that this virus is going to cause a lot of problem. So my advice to people is to be very cautious, take all the precautions, try to boost your immunity, do not unnecessarily venture out a lot, okay, because the virus has gathered some strength because of this Angarak Yog combination. Also, Venus going into the 12th house, Venus indicates luxury, comforts, partnerships, and 12th house indicates losses. So what does this mean? This means that throughout the year, our expenses may be on a higher side. Okay, people might get hospitalized and they may have to spend a lot of money. So that is what the position of Venus indicates. Venus is also the first lord in the 12th house. First house indicates the people of the country. 12th house indicates hospitalization. Okay, so we will see a lot of increase in people getting this virus and getting hospitalized. So people need to take care during this year. Ketu is in the 7th house of partnerships and relationships. Okay, so our relationships with the neighboring countries, that may come into a lot of conflict this year, especially with countries such as China, Pakistan, Myanmar, which are our neighbors, right? So we will see some problems with the neighboring countries. Now, in many of my previous videos, I had mentioned about a lot of scandals coming out in India, which is now happening. You can see what is happening in Maharashtra. I had also mentioned about a lot of violence in Bengal. That too has happened. So you might feel that I am covering a lot of negative events, but this year also has many good things, and let us cover that now. Now the good thing is that Jupiter has moved into the 10th house for this new year. That is, Jupiter is in the sign of Aquarius or Kumbh starting 6th April 2021, and therefore he has moved away from Saturn. He is still inside Saturn's house, but the influence of Saturn on Jupiter has greatly reduced, and Jupiter is now free to give good fruits. The 10th house indicates the government, okay, and therefore Jupiter's presence in Aquarius indicates a strong government, a government that can take good decisions for the welfare of people. Jupiter's fifth aspect falls on the second house, which indicates the finances, which indicates the wealth. And the second house right now is the sign of Gemini, on which Jupiter's aspect falls. Gemini also indicates communication. So you will also see the media becoming very powerful in times ahead. The government being able to take strong decisions for the welfare of people. Since Jupiter is in the 10th house, Jupiter indicates expansion. 10th house indicates career and business. So despite these lockdowns, etc., this year the businesses will not completely collapse. Okay, there will be good things that will be happening. There will be an expansion in the economy. Also look at the 9th house, which is the sign of Capricorn or Makar, where Saturn is placed. 9th house indicates the destiny. It indicates the good luck, good fortune. And Saturn is present in his own house, which means this year India's good luck will also multiply manifold. Okay, India will definitely get support from a lot of other countries, and it will be able to overcome the challenges that it is currently facing. So times will definitely improve because Saturn is present in the 9th house, in his own house of Capricorn. So not everything is bad. Now when the new year starts, it is very important to look at the position of Mercury or Buddh, because Buddh indicates communication, he indicates media, he indicates our nervous system. Okay, and Buddh is placed in the 11th house, in a debilitated state. Remember that Pisces is the debilitation sign of Mercury. Okay, and because Buddh is debilitated and Mars is going to move into the sign of Gemini, okay, it indicates the diseases that people get may be related to the nervous system. So when this virus spreads, it can impact the nervous system in a big way in this year. So that is also one negative side. Also, if you see very carefully, a Kalsarp Yog is formed on the start of New Year. Okay, and therefore there will be sudden events, sudden changes, but the government will be very strong and can take strong decisions. Since Saturn is well placed, Saturn is in his own house, the judiciary will be very strong. Okay, so a lot of cleaning is going to happen in the government. That is, all the corrupt politicians, all the corrupt people are slowly getting exposed. The good part of the new year is that Jupiter aspects the second house, he aspects the fourth house, and he also aspects the sixth house. So the red lines which I have drawn, they are showing Jupiter's aspect. Okay, and Jupiter's aspect falls on the sign of Gemini, it falls on the sign of Leo, and it falls on the sign of Libra or Tula. Okay, so despite all these challenges, Jupiter gives us the power to overcome these challenges. The country will do good in this year and the economy will not completely collapse. Saturn's aspects do create problems. Saturn is aspecting Mercury with his third aspect. Okay, you can see the top left square, which has the letters ME. ME indicates Mercury, and Saturn puts his third aspect on Mercury. So therefore, diseases related to the nervous system will increase this year. Mercury also indicates media, communication. Jupiter is aspecting the sign of Gemini, which is ruled by Mercury. And Mercury is also weak in the sign of Pisces, which means that rumors will very easily spread in this time period. So we must take care that we do not believe in false rumors. Okay, because Jupiter aspecting the sign of Gemini and the Lord of Gemini, that is Mercury, being weak indicates rumor spread very quickly this year. So be careful, always take information from genuine sources. Jupiter aspects the fourth house of Leo. Okay, and the fourth house is also known as the Janta Sthan, the Sukha Sthan, or the house of happiness. It indicates the happiness of people in the country. And Jupiter's aspect falling on the fourth house definitely indicates that this year will be much better than the last 2 years that we have gone through. Okay, so there will be struggles, but Jupiter will definitely give us the power to overcome all these struggles. Jupiter also aspects the sixth house, that is the sign of Tula or Libra, which indicates diseases, conflicts, etc. Okay, and Jupiter's aspect on the sixth house gives us the power to overcome conflicts, to overcome diseases, to overcome any challenges that come in the way of our country. So this is actually a good thing. Saturn aspecting the sign of Cancer with his seventh direct aspect indicates that border issues, border disputes will continue. Okay, India will face challenges from its neighbors such as Bangladesh, Pakistan and China. So all these things are going to continue. Saturn also aspects the sign of Tula, which is the sixth house, and the same sign is aspected by Jupiter also. What does this mean? It means that if diseases come in our way, if conflicts come in our way, still Jupiter gives us the power to overcome these things. Okay, and therefore this year is going to be much better than the previous years. The challenges will be there, but we will also have the power and strength to overcome them. So I would say 2021 is a mixed year for India. India will face a lot of challenges. The virus will also increase. Okay, but we will have the power to overcome these challenges by the grace of Jupiter or Guru. And therefore, if you surrender to your Guru, if you surrender to a true Guru, if you take his advice, definitely you are going to prosper this year. Now, it is also important to note that between September 14, 2021 and November 20th, 2021, Jupiter is going to re-enter the sign of Capricorn and become conjunct with Saturn. So the period from September to November of 2021 is going to be very stressful, because these two big planets are again going to be conjunct in the 10th house. Okay, that is the sign of Capricorn. In this case, for the new year, it is the 9th house. But what it indicates is, between September and November, there are going to be a lot of struggles in India. Okay, we may see border disputes, we may see earthquakes, we may see a lot of challenges in the period between September and November. But after that, things will become good. Okay, and even before this period, that is before September, things are very much better. So friends, this is my analysis of India's horoscope for the year 2021. And to summarize, I would say this is a mixed year where the virus continues to spread. Okay, it will pose challenges. It will also increase deaths in the country. But because of Jupiter's aspect falling on the second house, fourth house and the sixth house, there will be good things happening. We will have the power to overcome these challenges. The government becomes very strong. The judiciary becomes very strong. And corrupt people are completely exposed. So this year is a mixed year for India. I would say it is not very good, but it is definitely much better than the last 2 years. So friends, if you like this video, please mark it as liked on YouTube. If you have not subscribed to my channel Kamath Astrology, you can do so by clicking the subscribe button. So when I add a new video, you are automatically notified. For any consultations, any queries, please email us at astrosevaworld@yahoo.com and I'll be glad to assist you. To know more about us, visit our website astroseva.tripod.com. So friends, thanks a lot. We'll see you soon shortly with another video. Till then, bye. Stay home, stay safe, take care.